Hey guys, I am Amarjit Singh from motionmango.com. Welcome again to another very exciting tutorial. Let's take a quick look what we are going to create today. We are gonna be creating this cool cinematic title animation in After Effects without using any third-party plugins. You will get these all three project files as seen in the promo. Sounds good? So, without any further ado, let's jump right into the After Effects and get started. Alright, create a new composition. Let's call it text. I am going with HDTV 1080 preset with default frame rate and 10 seconds duration. Select the type tool and type the text. I am using the Azonix font. Link to the download is in the description below. Control double click the pan behind tool to move the anchor point to the center of the text. Align the text horizontally and vertically to the center of the screen. If you don't see the align panel here, just go to the Windows menu and click Align tab. Go to the Effects and Preset panel and find the text effect. Decrease tracking. Apply it to the text layer we have. Alright, press the U key on the keyboard to see the keyframes we just added. We can adjust the timing of the tracking. To make it organic, click here and open the graph editor and change it something like this. It will add some anticipation to the animation. Now make this layer 3D by clicking this button over here. Press Shift P to open the position properties along with the other properties. Move 10 frames forward and add a keyframe for the position. Move back to the first frame and change the Z position to negative value until the text is completely out of screen. In my case, around -2600 works fine for me. Now, go to the end tracking keyframe and increase the Z position a bit so it is always kept moving. Move forward by few frames and adjust its position to a very high value, creating the effect as it is moving far away out of the sight. Press Shift T to open up the opacity value along with the other properties and animate the opacity from 100 to 0. Let's preview this. If you see the animation a little unnatural, you can fix it easily. Click the Position tab, then right click on any position keyframe and click Keyframe interpolation and then change the auto bezier to linear. To make the position look organic, select the second keyframe, then keyframe assistant and select easy ease in. Now select the third keyframe and change it to easy ease out. Next, open the graph editor and change the graph to something like this. Let's preview this. Looks good. Alright, go to the end keyframe and press Alt drag it to trim the rest of the layer. Ctrl D to duplicate the layer and move it to end of the first layer. Duplicate a few more times and arrange the layers one after another. Change the text as required for all the layers. Now the basic setup is ready. Switch the motion blur for all the layers by clicking the motion blur button here. It's really important for achieving a more realistic motion effect. Let's preview this. Looks good to me. Alright, before we proceed, can you please spare a few seconds and subscribe to my channel? A lot of you right now watching this tutorial have not subscribed yet. I want to hit 5k subscriber to my channel this year, so please make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon. Well, create a new composition. Let's call it main. Drag the text comp into it. Ctrl D 2 times to duplicate the layer 2 times. Now select the bottom 2 layers, right click on it and select pre-compose. Let's name it bevel text. Open the bevel text comp, Select the upper layer. Now go to the effects and preset panel and find the effect fill. Apply the fill effect to the upper layer and change the fill color to black. Now find and apply the matte choker effect to it. Adjust the setting on the matte choker until the text appears with white blurry edges. Now import some assets. You can download the assets by clicking the link in the description. Click and drag the JPG file reflection map to the timeline just under the text comp. We can hide the bevel text comp for now. Go to the effects and preset panel, find and apply the motion tile effect to the reflection layer. Adjust the output width to around 1000. Click the stopwatch to add a keyframe for the tile center and animate it from left to right. It should be like this. Now, right click the reflection layer and click the pre-compose. Let's name it reflection. Select move all attributes and click OK. Change the track matte to alpha matte. Now find and apply an effect called CC glass to this reflection comp. In the effects control panel, change the bump map to bevel text layer and change the property to alpha. Adjust the softness and height and increase the displacement all the way to 500. Expand the light tab and change the light type to point light. Now find and apply another effect called CC Blobalize. Change the blob layer to bevel text layer and property to alpha. Decrease the softness a bit. Expand the light tab and change the light type to point light. Let's apply the curves effect now and adjust it to make the text more prominent. Make a new adjustment layer on top of all the layers. Now apply the curves effect to it and adjust the channels to give the scene a particular tone. I am trying the blue tone. You can try whatever color you like. Pretty damn good. From the project panel, drag the light spot to the timeline just under the adjustment layer. Change its blending mode to screen. And adjust the position to the top to add a little bit of halo. Ctrl D to duplicate it. And this time, move the layer just above the adjustment layer. Apply the curves effect to it. Make it reddish or whatever color you want. Then adjust the position to the bottom. Alright, now from the project panel, drag the particle.mp4 to timeline just under the reflection layer. You can download it by clicking the link in the description, as I mentioned earlier. Open the opacity property and change the opacity to 20%. Lastly, drag the lensflare.mov to the timeline on top of all the layers. Change the mode to screen. Now press Ctrl D and make multiple copies of this flare and adjust it on the timeline one after another. Go to the last frame of the animation. Press the N key to define the work area. Now right click the timeline and click trim comp to work area to get rid of the unwanted timeline. Create a new solid layer, make it black and hit OK. Double click the mask tool to add a mask to the layer. Now adjust the mask while pressing and hold the Ctrl plus Shift keys like this. Check the inverter to add a cinemascope to the animation. Let's preview this. Awesome. So that's pretty fun. And wrap up today's tutorial. We created this entire inside of After Effects without using any third-party plugins. So be sure to check back for another exciting tutorial soon. Till then, take care.